I'm in London at the Welcome Collection with Rafael Campo from Boston. And Rafael has just won the Open Hippocrates Prize for Poetry and Medicine. Rafael, what made you interested in this idea of the link between poetry and medicine?
Well, for me, it goes back to my experience growing up as the son of immigrant parents from Cuba. And I always felt a sense of disconnect from their experiences back on this forbidden island. And poetry, as it turned out, at a very early age for me, was a kind of bridge, a way of healing this fracture between my homeland, in many senses, and my life in the United States. And so poetry was important to me culturally, of course, because it was also a way of knowing about that experience in Cuba, but also it was truly a healing modality for me at that time in my life.
And we were talking earlier about you and your patients.
Oh, I think patients really are starved for opportunities to communicate more soulfully, really, with their care providers. And I've been involved in a number of writing groups for patients where I've seen the power of the patient's narrative, the story, and the ways in which we as medical providers perhaps appropriate that narrative, take it away, translate it into medicalese, and make it then incomprehensible to the very people who are living the story. So to give back some of that power, to really share in the story of the illness, I think has been tremendously powerful for patients, and really helps in their healing. I think they do find healing in their writing.
So you've made it all the way from Boston on the east coast of the US to come over here. So how did you hear about this prize that was set up from the UK?
Oh, well, it's a tremendously important prize. It's one of the most important prizes, certainly in the realm of poetry and medicine. And I heard about it actually through a fellow poet who has been a mentor of mine for many years and encouraged me to share my work and really become part of this international community responding to illness through poetry. So that's how I came to submit my work.
And your winning poet called Morbidity Mortality Rounds, what inspired you to write that?
That was a poem that really was a response to a specific patient of mine who I cared for some years ago who had hepatocellular carcinoma, liver cancer. And I remember very vividly coming to see him one day. He was actually doing very poorly at that point in his illness and was preparing to be transferred to a hospice. And he said to me at the time, very forlornly, you know, that he wanted to apologize to me for failing the treatment regimen that I had prescribed, and that in some sense he felt that he'd caused me trouble, and he felt sorry for that. And I remember feeling the irony, the very powerful irony of that, because I myself had felt so helpless in caring for him, and that the limitations of what I had to offer through biomedicine, the chemotherapy and the various other procedures and surgeries he'd gone through, weren't curative, and I had felt culpable. I had felt that we had, as a system, failed him. So that's what prompted me to write this poem, was to really bear witness to what I thought was really more truthful.